Hey everybody, this is Gilbert. Hey everybody, this is Gilbert. And today I'm going to be playing Jabberwocky. Let's see how this goes. So we start off with a Sicilian. Against the Sicilian, I like to play the open Sicilian. D4 just to break open in the center. And he captures. Something I don't like about this line is that oftentimes bishop can come here after I play knight to c3. So I don't think it really matters. I see a move like a6 and it's just a slow time burner. So let's just develop our pieces. G6. So after playing a6, it looks like the bishop has two doors. The bishop can come either this way or this way. And we see that now this bishop opts for this diagonal. It might be a good idea to blunt the scope of that bishop. So let's just prepare for the knight to be hit. Now I have to consider if I want to go kingside or queenside. I'm looking at where this bishop belongs. I know in some lines the bishop goes to e2 and the pawn goes to f3 and we start attacking on the kingside. So that might be a good idea since Black has kind of lost some time in the opening, and let's see. It might be a good idea to form this battery against this bishop. If this knight develops and he castles, I might be able to get my bishop here to trade off and then eventually start attacking with my pawns. So we have some tension now. If I capture, that's just me admitting I lost time. I like to look at queenside castle here because it looks like if he captures, I can capture back with my bishop and I'll be directly opposing his piece that would be defending the king otherwise. Let's just pre-move this capture. So see how he played knight to e7? He's trying to not block in his bishop, but we see that our pawn is doing a good job here. Where does this bishop belong? I think I'll play f3 just to cement my pawn structure. This pawn is doing a great job of battling this knight. Where is this piece going? So b5 attacking me. Do I need to respond to that? I know that whenever I castle on the queen side, normally people play king to b1. Do I need to do that right away? There might be some tactics against this knight. If this knight ever moves, I might be able to capture. I see I have two pieces here. It doesn't really work right now because of this. We have a knight that would capture, but maybe. What about knight takes, pawn takes, bishop takes? So I'm looking at this line. I'm looking at knight takes, pawn takes, bishop takes, but I see that we can get this. He can still capture, so it's not really fast enough. Am I scared of him playing b4? Maybe king b1 would be good. Let's just play king to b1. Let's get our king safe. So he opts to develop his bishop on this diagonal. Is that bishop really going to be doing anything against this pawn? I mean, I guess he's getting ready for D5, and he is protecting the knight again. It might be a good time to develop this bishop to E2, and then start expanding on the king side. But if I play bishop to E2 and he plays B4, where's my knight going? I suppose my knight could be going to here eventually, if it's kicked. Yeah, I'm not really worried about that right now. So the thing about the Sicilian is that if you play it as a lower player and you don't really know what you're doing, it's gonna be really hard for you to have an active position. It's really easy to be passive in the Sicilian, especially if you're not sure how to attack on the queen side. Normally for white has a clear plan to attack on the king side with a pawn storm if the king is there. In these kind of positions, you need to be ready to try to trade off the pieces. Okay, queen to a5. So I see that we have some indirect tension between the queens. The first thing I noticed is that this is no longer being defended. But the thing is, knight captures, bishop captures would lend the hand of the bishop. So I can't necessarily take right away. But maybe a move like knight to b3. Knight to b3 would hit pretty hard. But after knight to b3, what about moves like bishop captures? So knight to b3. Bishop captures, queen captures. Should I be trading queens here? Maybe a better move would be knight to b3, bishop captures, pawn captures. I know it looks ugly. If I capture the queen, knight to b3. You see, this bishop is pretty annoying. What do I play here? Is it possible for me to capture? If I just ignore the threat, capture here, I'm directly hitting this king. I see that if pawn captures, this guy's weak. So knight captures, f captures. It seems like we have some tension. Am I running out of squares there? Looks good for me. If I can pick up the bishop. But knight captures, what about. What about knight captures? Knight captures, bishop captures knight. Do I still check? Yeah, what I didn't like about queen to a5 is that you don't defend d7 anymore. How are you defending this? I mean, it looks too good to pass up. I'm gonna go for it. Let's see how he responds. See, in these kind of positions, you need to be careful with your king. Sometimes, if your king is stuck in the center, it's really easy for the position to become very tactical. It can get very wonky pretty soon. Let's see what Jabberwocky has in store for us. Okay, so I've captured. So we're just gonna go ahead and capture. We have the support of our battery. So should I just go ahead and capture the bishop? Is there any way I can keep attacking? After I capture, it's very likely that my opponent's gonna capture on c3. I'm gonna have doubled pawns and my kingside's gonna be weak. I gotta watch out for a move like knight to b4. So after bishop here, bishop captures, pawn captures, queen captures. I gotta be careful about this knight going into this square. Maybe this prevents it. So let's go for this. So he chops. Let's grab. Another move I just noticed is, whoa. I don't know what this move is about. I'm instantly looking at moves like bishop to b. Six, just attacking the queen, gaining some tempo. Another option is I can't exactly capture yet. Where is the queen going? After queen, is the queen going to a? To A3. Can I just capture my pawn? Pawn captures, knight captures, bishop to b. Bishop d2. Pawn captures, knight captures, bishop d2. How's that going? See, you have these threats. Can I handle that? What about a move like, pawn captures. Knight captures. Rook here. Should I even be allowing this much activity? What if I just push? Why do I want this to open up? I don't. Let's close the position. I gotta be careful of my queen not getting trapped here. I'm running out of squares. Do I have any checks? No, doesn't seem like it. Let's just scoot over. I like this pin I got going on here, but it doesn't seem like it's gonna last for much longer. What's going on here? I gotta watch my time. See, so the thing about this move, B3, is that I have two defenders there. Is he really gonna sack? Am I in trouble here? Can I just capture? I thought I could just capture here. If capture is knight. What am I doing against knight to B? Knight B4, knight B4. Knight B4 is interesting. How am I dealing with that? So let's see. Pawn captures, knight to b4. What am I doing there? Can I just play here? Queen down. No, we have a pin. No, we don't. Yeah, I'm not really sure here, and I'm running out of time. See, my sister just walked in the room and I'm trying to record this video. I guess she didn't listen to me. Let's see, so we have some discover attacks here. But I think I can just move out of the way. Pieces going. I don't want to get checked again. I'm attacking the knight. I gotta start speeding up. Are there any threats? So I miss this check. Is that checkmate? Yeah, I lost. I guess my first game is a loss, man.